For this piece, I started in my sketchbook. Then I did a tracing to tighten up the composition and get the position of the kangaroo rats just right. I started with an indigo blue because that's a great color for a lot of shadows. You get color, you know, you might just think a shadow is dark gray or black, but I like to do my shadows with that hidden color. And that was going to contrast really nice with the rest of the sky. I try to do that all in once, making sure I have plenty of paint so that I can go wet on wet, even with acrylic paint. It dries quickly, so I have to move fast. Not as fast as the painting shows. Also, that other paintbrush that you see flying around isn't some second magical paintbrush. I just have a habit of holding paintbrushes in my mouth. So here I'm blocking in this beautiful rosy color and covering all the canvas and starting to get some texture into the background and painting little rock piles in the distance. Using my liner brush to just create texture and little lumps and bumps. And in this is just one manzanita tree that you'll recognize if you've spent any time in the desert at all. It's part of that sweet smell when it starts to rain. And what I really was hoping to do was that when people look at this painting, they get their senses engaged and start to smell that sweet, wet, earthy smell that the desert produces when there's moisture in the air. It's just such a sweet smell of the manzanita and creosote and all the sages. This sand texture was really challenging. And so I had to do a lot of fine stippling. Here I'm starting to sketch in the rats with chalk. And then I come in with some gesso primer and sketch them in. I find that that's a really good way to make them stand out, as if they have a primer underneath them that's bright like white, so whatever colors I'm using will show up like a very fine layer in the foreground. These little rats are just pretty amazing. They're so well adapted for life in the desert. A fun fact is that they actually don't drink water. They get all of the moisture that they need from the seeds that they eat, so they can inhabit the driest climates, and they're very widespread all over California, but particularly in the Mojave Desert. So this was just a scene out of my imagination. I didn't get to witness this one, but it just came from my wondering, what would it be like the moment it starts to rain for a family of kangaroo rats? This would bring a lot of food and just a welcome relief from the heat. The hardest thing about designing this piece was the subtlety. I wanted the rats to look like they were just popping off, all jump in at once, rather than dancing like a Disney cartoon. I think I succeeded in making that happen. And with the final drops of rain as the last detail, that's all, folks. Thank you.